Riding out of the blue corner, he weighed in at 77 kilograms. He's making his semi-pro mixed martial arts debut. He represents London Fight Factory. Please put your hands together for Aaron Ramas! His opponent this evening, fighting out of the red corner, he weighed in at 76 kilograms. He has an unblemished record of 2 wins, no losses. He represents Team KFA. Please put your hands together for Steve O'Halloran. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a semi-pro mixed martial arts contest to be held at 2 4-minute rounds.
As you can hear, 2 very well supported young men here. Aaron Ramas from the London Fight Factory making his debut against Steve O'Halloran from Team KFA, who is 2-0. Very much like earlier in the night, Nick, where a very confident young man made his debut again against an opponent that was 2-0 and got the win. And here, Aaron Ramas, a huge height advantage over the stockier Steve O'Halloran.
Yeah, there's short and stocky versus tall and lean. Let's see if he puts his nice slip, and he's immediately going for that single leg takedown. He's got to watch out for his neck. Pulled out nicely. Excellent single leg takedown against the cage.
Yes, as you said, O'Halloran looked for the neck as he took him down, but Ramas got him where he needed him.
Big body shots by Ramas there, generating a lot of power. Not many fighters, especially at semi-pro, can get good body shots off like Ramas is doing. Big right hand to the solar plexus.
Yes, left and right's coming through, picking his spots. Now here, if you're underneath that, taking those shots, what would you be doing as Steve O'Halloran, Nick?
Well, luckily for Steve, he's right in his corner, so his coaches will be shouting out at him, telling him what to do. He needs to work up the cage, back to his feet. He can't stay here. Managed to get guard back. Let's see if he's offensive. He's looking for the armbar.
Yes, he's looking for that left arm, wasn't it? But
I think it's Ramos's right arm, actually, and it might be in quite deep. He's got to use his left arm to... He's doing the right thing there, protecting it, locking it in, and now he's jerking it out, and now it's safe, and he's in side control. But again, Steve shows he's got some offense off his back now. Ramas can't be sleeping on that.
That's right, it's given him something to think about. He's got to be careful.
Might have, especially on his debut, could be getting a little overexcited, forgets about the basics, but that's going to be a wake-up call for him now.
And again, at semi-professional level, it's all about the work. You're not allowed to strike to the head from the ground there.
Let's see if he traps the arm there with his left hand and unloads some right shots. Wants to attack the floating ribs. Make every shot count.
Yes, and as you said, he's managed to generate real power there to that rib cage.
Good shoulder pressure there. Looking to achieve a more dominant position, maybe side control or mount. But he's certainly winning the fight at this moment.
Yes, nice transitioning there.
Yeah, he's got to keep the weight off his knees and on his opponent. No point letting the floor carry his weight. Let's see if he spins to take Steve's back. Looking for a dart strike perhaps. Posturing up, land some more shots. These are going to start to take their toll on Steve and eat away at his cardio.
Well, we saw that Steve O'Halloran is more than capable off his back, but he's only been given the one opportunity so far in this round. And as we've mentioned throughout the night, you have only got 2 rounds to impress here at semi-pro level.
That's right. What I used to tell my fighters is try for a minute or so, and if it's not happening, change it up. You've got to get back to your feet. You've got to hit a sweep. We haven't got time to waste. Throwing up a reverse triangle attempt there and attacking the arm at the same time. Not quite locked it up, and Ramas is able to escape.
So O'Halloran has proved he's dangerous.
He's dangerous, but is he going to get the submission? If he isn't, he's got to change up his game plan.
Well, if he doesn't get the submission in this round, the way Aaron Ramos has gone about his work, he will have lost this opening round, won't he?
Absolutely. And the fighters are going to be more sweaty for the next round, and it'll be harder to find that submission in the second.
So again, from the London Fight Factory, we've got a man making a very assured debut.
Confident and skilled debut.
And we had a perfect view there, Nick, of the body language of both men. And there's real frustration in Steve O'Halloran there. He wanted to walk over to the other corner as they were in the break. You could see the pleasure on Ramos's face as a job well done in the first. And right in front of us, O'Halloran looks so frustrated with himself, didn't he?
He looks frustrated. His corner men have to calm him down. Get through to him, build his confidence, help him reset and approach the second round completely differently. They're only halfway through. He's got it. He can easily win this fight if he goes about it in the right way.
He showed under pressure. He's got the technical skills, hasn't he?
That's right. I'd like to see what his top game is like this round, and maybe a bit of striking from both the fighters.
Well, as you said, in that first round, he started with a big right hand that actually caused him to be taken down, wasn't it? Maybe a bit more control, a bit tighter boxing from it.
But you can see the confidence brimming from Aaron. He's growing in confidence with each moment. And he believes he's destined to win this fight.
Yes, their body language very different from the two men.
Big overhand rights from Steve there. Yes. This is much better from him. This is what he needs to be doing.
Those bolo punches against the taller man, almost like bowling a cricket ball. There you go, and it lands this time. And as you said, the corner got a chance to talk to him, calm him down, and a much better start. Nice sprawl and turn as
Excellent.
Well.
Excellent. He used a cross face to defend that takedown, and now he's on top. This is much more for his style.
Looking to get that back.
Aaron needs to keep his chin down.
And Nick, this is what I love about MMA in particular, the way fortunes can change in an instant.
And this is what makes it such a fantastic sport for the crowd here. Back and forth action, on the floor, on the feet. Steve doing a much better job here. He's finding his distance now, stopping the takedowns, even put a spinning back kick in. You know the guys feels good when they try that.
But again, very confident young man is Aaron Ramos in his debut here.
Yeah, hands very low, showboating a bit there. Wants to be careful though.
Yes, because he missed with the left, with the right this Steve, but he tagged him with a little left hook.
No need for having your hands that low in your debut. Keep pumping his jab is what he should be doing. Pepper Steve's face, land the jabs on the nose, distract him and then go for the takedown.
Oh, nice right leg kick to the head of O'Halloran, but he shrugs it off.
Yeah, that landed, caught him just behind the ear. Steve showing good tenacity.
Just a bit over anxious with his punches though, I feel. It's almost like he's shown you how much he wants to get back into this fight.
Well,
they're just a bit loose.
His undefeated record's on the line here. He's sensing the desperation after losing that first round, but you're right, he's a bit overzealous perhaps.
Yeah, a bit tighter with those punches, a bit cleaner, better effect.
Looking for the single leg takedown is Steve against the cage. Wants to get better head position here. You don't want to be looking at the floor when you're against the cage. Aaron trying to turn him here. Steve trying to pick up the high crotch for a slam, but because Aaron's got the right underhook, he managed to survive.
Yeah, a little knee to the inside of the thigh of Aaron. But watch the back of the head, I think he was warned there as he punches down on
Aaron. Potentially looking to wrap up a Kimura here on Steve's left arm. They separate. Look for Steve to learn that big right overhand.
He needs to take a half a step in.
Yeah, there's a lot of distance to cover here. That's what Aaron needs to be doing. Landing the jab, sticking it out.
Well, that flailing right hand did land on Aaron.
Aaron's starting to get his jab working nicely now, but Steve's having none of it. Closes the distance, bombards him.
Exchange of knees from both men. It's a much closer second round, Nick.
Yep.
And it's been upright virtually the whole time, in contrast to the first round, which was on the ground the whole time.
Very.
And in many ways, Steve Halloran has been the aggressor.
Yes, this has been a very exciting round. Aaron using the cross face here, and he gets the takedown. Steve is on his back again. This is where Aaron wants to fight. Again, working the ground and pound to the body.
And Nick, if he keeps it here from now, this could be key to this fight, if he can keep Steve here.
There's the clapper. He wants to unload, leave it all in the cage. 10 seconds hard work.
Well, Nick, in the first London Fight Factory fight, we thought it was very close, but we edged it to the blue corner. I'm going to take a chance. I've got a feeling the corner's going to take it again. Just a feeling.
I'm not going to doubt you on that one, Malcolm.
I felt Steve O'Halloran far better in the second round, far more aggressive, but you can see on his face again, he had a game plan, and I don't think it quite happened for him.
Much, much better from Steve in the second round, and a third round would have been very interesting.
Yes, I agree with you. So I feel it's a closer decision than the first fight that London Fight Factory won, but I've just got a feeling that both their debutants might be winning tonight.
But unfortunately, there can only be one. And that one has won by way of unanimous decision. Fighting out of the blue corner, please put your hands together for Aaron Ramas. And a round of applause for his opponent, Steve O'Halloran.